Good morning, and welcome to this May 15, 2022, Fifth Sunday of Easter media cast of the Hines Memorial Christian Methodist Episcopal Church, located at 408 North Madison Street, Albany, Georgia, 31701, where the pastor is the Reverend Dr. Orl Spragan, Jr. The presiding elder is the Reverend Dr. Bobby K. Galladay, Sr., and the presiding prelate is Bishop Thomas L. Brown, Sr. We pray in the name of Jesus that you will be blessed by today's service, that you will accept the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior, and that the Spirit of the Lord will prevail in your life. Let us pray. God, we thank you for this day that you have given us, allowing us to see it and to gather and worship in your name. Thank you for watching over us through the day thus far and through the night and through the week. For God, we know that we have been through many dangers, seen and unseen. We have heard of disasters and catastrophes and happenings all around the world, and even in our own neighborhoods, O God. And we have been kept from many of those, O Lord. And we say thank you because we know it has been by the power of your hand. And at the same time, Lord, there are some things that we have experienced. There are some tragedies. There have been some sicknesses. There have been some discontentment, O God. There have been some disappointments. And you have kept us through them all. You have lifted us and you have been with us through them. And you have helped us to have faith and to maintain hope throughout them, O God. And we have seen your great mercy. We have seen your powerful hand. We have experienced your love. We have received your encouragement. We have been filled and touched by your Holy Spirit. And again, God, we have to say thank you, because we know also that all these things, the avoidance of disaster and helping us through disaster, are by you and you alone. You are God, and beside you there is no other. And so we say thank you. We also, Lord, in recognizing that you are God, see ourselves, and we know that you are holy, that you are righteous, that you are high and lifted up. And we see ourselves, O God, in need of your mercy. We see ourselves as unrighteous sinners. We see ourselves as those who have disobeyed your commands. We see ourselves, Lord, even as those who have not studied your command, who have not sought to know your will. We see ourselves, O God, as those who have not loved as you have commanded us and desired us to love. We see ourselves, O God, as falling short of your word and your will. We see ourselves, O God, not living up to the image that you have placed within us, and not even according to the calling of your Son, Jesus. And O God, we confess today that we are sinners in need of your grace, and we ask humbly, we come bowing before you, asking, O God, that you will forgive us of our sins, that not only will you forgive us, O God, but that you will cleanse us and free us from ungodliness and free us, Lord, from the guilt, and place your Spirit in us in a new way, that, Lord, we may seek to know you and to follow you and to love you in obedience and in doing your will, in loving one another, O God, even as you love us. Help us, Lord, to do that. Open our eyes, O God, and help us to see you. Open our eyes, O God, and help us to walk in the way you have placed before us. Open our eyes, O God, and help us to see and to study and to have a mind after you, O God. Help us to have the mind that was in Christ Jesus, O God. We ask, O Lord, this day that as we continue in this worship service, that you will speak to us and teach us and lead us and guide us and help us to yet become all that you would have us to be. That in the end, when you come to judge the quick and the dead, when you come to judge the living and the dead, Lord, those who are raised up and those, Lord, who yet remain, but who you will come to in this life, O God, who have not yet seen death. We ask, O Lord, that you would help us, prepare us, make us ready to meet you, O God, in that day, in that great day, in that great getting up morning, in the great day of judgment, O God. Help us to be ready to meet you at that time, that you may receive us joyfully before your throne and bring us into everlasting life, where we may live with you and praise your holy name forevermore. We ask these things in the name of Jesus, who is the Christ, our God and Savior. Amen.
I know that Our Old Testament scripture this morning can be found in Psalm 148, verses 1 through 14, King James Version. Psalm 148, verses 1 through 14, King James Version. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise ye him, all his angels. Praise ye him, all his host. Praise ye him, sun and moon. Praise him, all ye stars of light. Praise him, ye heavens of heavens, and ye waters that be above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded, and they were created. He hath also established them forever and ever. He hath made a decree which shall not pass. Praise the Lord from the earth, ye dragons and all deeps, fire and hail, snow and vapor, stormy wind fulfilling his word, mountains and all hills, fruitful trees and all cedars, beast and all cattle, creeping things and flying fowl, kings of the earth and all people, princes and all judges of the earth, both young men and maidens, old men and children, let them praise the name of the Lord. For his name alone is excellent. His glory is above the earth and heaven. He also exalted the horn of his people, the praise of all his saints, even of the children of Israel, a people near unto him. Praise ye the Lord. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and doing of his holy word.
Testament scripture reading is found in the book of Acts, chapter 11, verses 7 through 18. Acts, chapter 11, verses 7 through 18. King James Version. And I heard a voice saying unto me, Arise, Peter, slay and eat. But I said, Not so, Lord, for nothing common or unclean hath at any time entered into my mouth. But the voice answered me again from heaven, What God hath cleansed, that call not thou common. And this was done three times, and all were drawn up again into heaven. And behold, immediately there were three men already come unto the house where I was, sent from Caesarea unto me. And the Spirit bade me go with them, nothing doubting. Moreover, these six brethren accompanied me, and we entered into the man's house. And he showed us how he had seen an angel in his house, which stood and said unto him, Send men to Joppa, and call for Simon, whose surname is Peter, who shall tell thee words whereby thou and all thy house shall be saved. And as I began to speak, the Holy Ghost fell on them, as on us at the beginning. Then remembered I the word of the Lord, how that he said, John indeed baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost. For as much then as God gave them the like gift as he did unto us, who believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, what was I that I could withstand God? When they heard these things, they held their peace and glorified God, saying, Then hath God also to the Gentiles granted repentance unto life. The Lord bless the reading, hearing, and doing of his holy word.
Yeah.
Today's message is titled, Blind Eyes Opened, and is based in Acts chapter 11, verses 17 through 18. Those verses read from the King James Version, For as much then as God gave them the like gift as he did unto us, who believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, what was I that I could withstand God? When they heard these things, they held their peace and glorified God, saying, Then hath God also to the Gentiles granted repentance unto life. Let us pray. God, in this preaching moment, open our eyes, our blinded eyes. Help us to see, to love what you love, to do what you would have us to do. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Blind eyes open. We're not talking about blind Bartimaeus today, the man who sat beside the road and begged and heard Jesus was coming and then hollered that he wanted to see Jesus and wouldn't stop until Jesus told him to come and asked what he wanted and gave him his sight. Neither are we talking about the man who was told by Jesus to go and wash in the pool of Siloam after Jesus had anointed his eyes and came back seeing. And people asked him about it, including leaders in the Jewish religious leadership. No, we're not talking about those persons. Today's sermon is about people who have the use of the natural sight, the natural use of their eyes, but still fail to see what is right before them, what is right in front of them. You may have heard the expression, eyes wide shut. It refers to persons who have the natural use of sight and have all of their capacities, but still fail to see what is right in front of them, who fail to believe what is right in front of them, to fail to believe and accept as true that which is true and obvious. Their eyes are wide shut. And so that's where we find the Apostle Peter in today's text, and where we find the disciples in Jerusalem in today's text. Their eyes are wide shut and need to be opened, and it is the Holy Spirit who does the opening. In Acts chapter 11, verses 1 through 18, we find the story of Peter at Joppa and the man Cornelius who has had a heavenly vision and who has sent to Joppa to get Peter and have him to come back to his house and to preach to him and his household. And before Peter finishes the sermon, the Holy Spirit falls on them and they begin to speak with other tongues. And this is because they have believed the gospel even while Peter is preaching. Doesn't have to wait to the end of the message. They don't wait until the end of the sermon. They believe the message. They believe the gospel. And God gives proof of their belief by showering them with the Holy Spirit, just as he showered the disciples with the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. And so it is that Peter is now standing before the disciples in Jerusalem telling this story, and the disciples in Jerusalem are finding it hard to believe. In fact, they doubt it. They disbelieve it. They put all kinds of obstacles in the way because their eyes are spiritually wide shut. Now, Peter, of course, himself was in this situation. Peter, of course, is the one who had an initial vision from God of a sheet coming down full of unclean animals. And then the voice says to Peter, arise, slay, and eat. And Peter responds, nothing unclean has ever crossed these lips and is not going to happen today. And three times he says that to God. After God tells him three times, slay and eat. And Peter says, no. And God says, slay and eat. And Peter says, no. And God says, slay and eat. And Peter says, no. And God says, do not call unclean that which God has made clean. Don't call it common just because you see it as common, just because it doesn't look like what you are used to looking at, just because in your mind it cannot be so. It cannot be this way. It's unacceptable. God says, I have made it acceptable, and I am the one who said it was unclean. I am the one who now says it is clean. I am the one who tells you it's all right. Don't dispute with me. You don't know what the Lord has done. I remember an old preacher, Reverend Warfield, who used to sing a song all the time, you don't know what God has done for me. You don't know what the Lord has done for me. You don't know when, you don't know where. You don't know what the Lord has done for me. And that's what was coming out of this story, out of the actions, out of the experience of Peter with Cornelius and his household and with Peter and the disciples. Peter was telling the disciples, the others, you don't know what God has done, but let me tell you the story. Let me tell you, listen to me. If you will be led, God will surprise you wonderfully and give you great joy in unexpected places, even the unexpected place of yourself, even in your own heart, in your own mind, with your own sight. God will do unexpected things if you will just allow him to open your blinded eyes. Peter was surprised at the vision. Peter was surprised at what God was telling him to do, but he was greater surprised and thrilled even at the sight of the Holy Spirit at work when he got out of Joppa and went down to Caesarea and experienced the preaching and the revival that took place in Cornelius' house. He was surprised at the first vision, but he was greater surprised and overjoyed at the second one. It took him by surprise. Eyes that are closed, blind with prejudice, cannot see the glory of God. To what or to whom have you blinded eyes? In Psalm 148, we read that God says, praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord from the heavens. The psalmist is speaking under the influence of the Holy Spirit. Praise him in the heights. And then he goes on to talk about beast and cattle and creeping things and flying fowl and goes on to talk about kings of the earth and all people, princes and all judges of the earth, both young men and maidens, old men and children. What the psalmist is saying here, what God is saying through the psalmist is everything, everybody ought to praise the Lord. Everything ought to praise the Lord. And then he talks about that, you know, if you look at it, everything that is above in the heavens praises God, should praise the Lord, does praise the Lord. Let all that is in the earth praise the Lord, the cattle and the beast and the fowl and the fish and what have you. Let them praise the Lord, and they praise the Lord in their own way. But and then the scripture says, we also praise the Lord when we lift his name. Now look at it. Everything else is designed, is made to praise him. But we, his human creation, are chosen to praise him by his command. He tells us, you have a choice, but I have chosen you to praise me. And just like everything else that I created praises me, all creation praises me, you ought to praise me too. We ought to praise him too. Not because we have been made to praise him and we have no choice, but because we have been made to praise him and we do have a choice, and we ought to choose to praise him because we know how good and great he is. We know his name is excellent in all the earth. In Revelation chapter 21, John had a vision. Here's another vision. In Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 through 6, John has another vision. And the whole book of Revelation is vision. But in Revelation 21, these first six verses, John says, I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. John says, things that I was used to seeing, they didn't exist anymore. And there will come a time when this earth as we know it and the heavens as we know them will exist no more. And there will be a new heaven and a new earth and a new existence. And all creation, though designed to praise God, will be done away with. We who are chosen shall remain forever. Humans shall remain forever. Humans are designed, are made, were created by God to go from this earthly existence as we know it into an eternal existence that we have yet to know and understand. Our praise of the Eternal One, however, begun in earth shall continue in heaven. That's what John saw. But also bear in mind that when John saw this, when John had this vision, when God gave John this vision, the vision was not limited to any one group, any one nation, any one race of people. Whatever the distinction is, it was not just one. No, it was everyone, all people. God doesn't see as we see. God doesn't differentiate like we human beings differentiate among each other. We differentiate according to color, according to nation, and all kinds of other things that we come up with to say, you are not like me. God doesn't see us that way. God sees one. God sees people. God's differentiation is between humans and animals, between that which is temporary and that which is everlasting, between that which is right and that which is wrong, evil and good, unrighteous and righteous, holy and unholy. Those are the distinctions that God sees. And John's vision says that those who are human will move from this earthly reality that we now understand and see into a new reality. Yes. In John chapter 13, Jesus spoke to his disciples. And in verse 35, he said, by this shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if ye have love one to another. He wasn't talking to the folk out there somewhere. He was talking to his disciples. He was saying, you need to learn to love each other. This was a group that had all kinds of differences between them, coming from different lands and speaking different dialects, perhaps, and having different cultures. But all disciples of Jesus, and he said, you need to learn how to love each other. Because when you learn to love each other, that's how the folk out there will know that you are my disciples. And when you learn to love each other with the eyes of God, then other folk can see that. And you can love them with the eyes of God. And they will be drawn to the Lord Jesus through you. And that's what Jesus was saying. Yes, you are my disciples to learn of me, to love me, to speak of me, to draw others to me. And they will see it by the way you love each other. So don't walk around with your eyes wide shut. This command was given to the fellowship of disciples. And Jesus was saying there's some problems in the fellowship and there will be some problems in the fellowship. But open your eyes. Let the Spirit open your eyes so that you can see. The beginning of love is to see each other with the eyes of Jesus, with eyes that see each other as persons of equal worth, of equal value, not only in the eyes of God. Not only do we say that God loves you, but we also say, I love you. Let's no longer walk about with blind eyes, with eyes wide shut, talking about who God
won't save, who God can't save, who God doesn't desire to save. No, God desires in Jesus to save us all. And that's what Peter needed to understand and learn. That God desired to save the Gentiles, just as God had desired to save the Jews. Peter and his group, they weren't exclusive. They acted like they were exclusive. They wanted to be exclusive, and God was telling them through Peter, you are not exclusive. I love all. All need to be saved. Yes, there is a judgment, but God was saying there is an opportunity for everyone to quit the walk of sin and be saved. And I'll save them just like I saved you. Let's no longer walk around with blind eyes, with eyes wide shut. Rather, let us open our eyes. Ask the Lord to give us spiritual sight by the power of the Holy Spirit that we may receive and embrace the heavenly vision for humanity in Jesus' name, in the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
whether in person or by social media. Thank you for joining us today for this May 15, 2022, 5th Sunday in Easter media cast of the Hines Memorial Christian Methodist Episcopal Church. We pray this service has been a blessing to you, and that the Lord will use it to draw you close to Him, to trust in Him, and to continue to help you through the week. If you receive the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior today, we rejoice with you in thanking God that you have chosen to put your trust in Christ, and invite you to join us as a member of the family of Hines Memorial. We also pray that you will continue to receive these services as a means to your discipleship and spiritual growth. Please write to us or email us at hinesmemorial@gmail.com to let us know how the Lord is blessing you. Thank you for your prayers, presence, participation, and support. Contributions may be mailed in, picked up, or given electronically by downloading the Givelify app and then searching for the Hines Memorial CME Church in Albany, Georgia. Follow the steps in the app to make your contribution. You may also mail your contributions to us at Hines Memorial CME Church, 408 North Madison Street, Albany, Georgia, 31701. Please continue to be safe, wearing your mask, sanitizing your hands, maintaining social distance according to CDC and WHO guidelines, and if you have not done so, please consider strongly receiving a COVID-19 vaccination and or booster. Here are some additional announcements and observations. Daily scripture readings are provided through the online ministry of Vanderbilt University Library.
From the Commission on Social Justice and Human Concerns, Georgia's primary election is May 24, 2022. Early voting will end on May 20th. The next election will take place in November. Participation is needed in both the primary and general elections. You should have your absentee ballot by now if you requested it earlier this year. The Albany Regional Senior Resource Fair will be held on May 27th from 9 until noon at 335 West Society Avenue. This event is being sponsored by Sewego Council on Aging, Georgia Senior Farmers Market, Nutrition Health Education. Free giveaways and more will be available for participants. Seniors and caretakers, please attend. Thank you to all of those who attended our church conference this past Wednesday and our quarterly conference on yesterday. Our reports show stability and improvement in many areas. If you are not an active part of our family and fellowship, we welcome you to become involved in the life of Hines Memorial, thereby boosting your own spiritual growth while you encourage others in the faith. The 11th Episcopal District will present a Zoom webinar, Expanding the Body of Christ, a three-day dedication service of over 180 new churches in Eastern Africa on May 16th through 18th, 2022 at 7 p.m. Central Time nightly. View via the CME Church's Facebook page or Zoom. Link information may be found on the internet at www.thecmechurch.org. Today's service is available via Pastor Spragan's YouTube channel. You may also listen via phone at 10:45 a.m. Eastern by dialing 1-978-990-5000 and using the access code 151404. Please minister to our sick, shut-in, and others with your prayers and other acts of support. Sister Ella Miller, Sister Mary Williams, Sister Geneva Hill, Sister Juanita Miller, Sister Janet Edwards, Brother Michael Sanderson, Sister Julia Williams Harris, Brother Charles Harris, Brother Marquavius Mason, Brother Prince Brooks, Brother Keith Lemon, Sister Henrietta Benson, Sister Judith Namasaka and family, Reverend Lydia Spragan. On Wednesday, May 18th, we will have Bible study at 12 noon. The call-in number is 1-978-990-5000, and the access code is 151-404. Our scriptures for this week are Psalm 133, Leviticus 19, verses 9 through 18, and Luke chapter 10, verses 25 through 28. We'd like to wish a happy birthday on Friday, May 20th, to Sister Geneva Hill. And on Saturday, May 21st, we would like to wish a happy birthday to Sister Rosalind James.
Thank you for joining us in worship today. It is our prayer that you will join us again next Sunday at 10:45 a.m. Eastern Time. Until then, continue in the worship and praise of God. Have faith in Jesus and live in the hope and power of His resurrection. May God keep you in His perfect peace. In Jesus' name, amen.